All right, welcome back. We're on the play, obviously. And this hand is quite strong. We're not going to play off curve in order to trigger our Seneca dies, unless we draw something. Like, we're not going to wait and not make a play is basically what I'm saying. If we had another two in our hand, we would probably cast that before the Dead Reveler, but we're not going to just pass the turn. Like that guy, I will definitely play. Obviously not attacking. Now if we draw another two drop, I'll cast that, otherwise I'll cast Dead Reveler here. We're getting beat over the head. Four spot. Pay one of these guys. Can't pay the other. Yes. Now it's true that he could double block and just kill my guy, but it's a pretty big risk for him to take. And I'm not worried about the defense. I have two other defensive cards coming down. And I could draw a million cards that make that bad, obviously. Fatal Fumes. I actually have one of those cards to make that awful in my hand, but I'm not going to cast them yet because I want to get some cipher or some extort triggers. Right, he's going to combat. Stack on one duder. Stack with two duders. Alright, that's aggressive. So he's casting something large. Ooh. But I get to, ooh, what does that do? It's actually pretty good because he's going to block the Dead Reveler. I'm just going to pay both times here and gain a ton of life. Then I gain the four life here as well. Kill his guy. Back up to 20. Got his dude off the table. And bought myself a turn to rip another land potentially and cast Perilous Shadow for full value. Reason I couldn't attack with 2-1, of course, is that he can potentially choose to block that. He's not going to block a 2-2 over a 3-2 or a 3-4 because he can't kill either one. But he can block a 2-1, value that one higher, simply because he can cast it or whatever. So if I attack, he's going to trade there. I don't want that to happen. So I'm just going to play this guy. Kick twice. Like, extort puts you pretty far ahead just gradually. You didn't even realize that. Like, it's 12 to 20 right now, even though we've made basically one attack all game. And this mob obstat's going to be pretty sick, because it looks like the board's stalling out, and that's when he's at his best. If you don't know the play pattern with him, is generally attack with your stuff, things that are things that get blocked and are not going to kill whatever they are, whatever they're being blocked by. You sacrifice those, pump up the rest of your team, and you have a jolly good time. Ooh, Blood Baron. Sure. Maybe I should just cast a small wobs at that first. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm a little scared to run the Blood Baron out into removal, and I'm not under enough pressure to really warrant it, so I'll play this guy. He'll eat a removal spell too. Like here, if I attack with these two guys, if I attack with everything, what happens? Nothing really bad. I'm gonna end up sacrificing one guy to eat something of his, probably. Yeah. So I could, yeah, they just sacrifice that guy. I get in for a punch. Alright, so he's down to 8. Pretty good. We did lose an extorter. But with Mob, Obsidian out, and Blood Baron, I don't know, feels pretty safe. We could have not made that attack. It was a 7-point attack, though. It's a pretty big deal. Alright, we can assume he does not have a removal spell. Ooh, let's play this on this guy and kill him. I don't know. I don't think so. I think I'll play this guy. So far I haven't missed out on any extorts from or Tide Drinker. And he would have to extort at least, like, I would say 5 times to equal the 7 damage that he got in. Dealing 5, gaining 5 is probably about equal to 7 damage, I would say. Because you have to spend mana and whatnot. So far, he couldn't have done any of that, so he's still big zip on the board. When I cast a stab wound, he would have gotten a trigger off, obviously. Ooh, Fatal Fumes. What does that do for me? I kill something. If I just attack with this, what happens? He can't just like throw a million things in front of it. Maybe he can actually. I guess I have sacrifice. All right, here we're gonna go. I'm gonna turn these three guys sideways. I have a Fatal Fumes to protect this. Alright, he's double blocking there. Nope. He can't block this with these two guys, so that's why I think this is a decent attack. Because his best blockers are both green, and his green guys are the things that have to block the Blood Baron. So right now I'm trading. Let's make this guy one. Alright, so I'm trading Maw to get in a bunch of damage, gain 4 life. Not getting in a bunch of damage, but getting a 1, I guess. He's losing Keening Apparition, which makes Stab Wound good. He's losing one of these two guys, I guess. Obviously, this guy. It's not even that bad for me. I want to keep the Cynic of Tides over the Maw after this, so he's done his job. Even if this doesn't kill the battering Croesus. Oh, I was just scooping. I was going to say, even if it doesn't kill the Croesus, it should keep it from killing me, like if he has some spell for it. I don't think I want any of this stuff, so.